Got him.
Got him, got him, got him. There we go.
All right, so one of the things that I've done with some of my spare time, not that I've had a ton of it, but I've tied a fair amount. So I've tied some hare's ears, sexy waltz, tied some rainbow warriors, tungsten surveyors, knot flies. I haven't done squirmy worms, which I wish I had done, but on Muddy Creek here, this is a fly fishing only section, and there is a good mix of wild browns as well as rainbows and stock browns. So, you know, these fish oftentimes are pretty opportunistic to hit some of the fake, you know, imitation flies of worms, maybe, you know, the mop. They're going to hit some of the junk flies, essentially, is what I'm saying. But don't get me wrong, there is, again, a nice healthy population of wild browns in here, too. So today, what I'm going to use is I'm going to use a mop fly as my point fly, and I'm going to use a rainbow warrior. But anyway, I am going to use those two flies today, and I'm hopeful that, you know, I've already heard there's active fish. I'm going to hit a couple holes real quick and run this through there. Probably got, you know, somewhere around 4 feet of tippet, and then as usual, I've got that tag fly that I'm going to use. But this spot right over here along that bank where it gets nice and deep, there's usually some really nice fish in there, so I'm hoping I can find some active feeding fish on this little bit chilly 40-45 degree day. But let's get after them, see how we do.
Got him, got him, got him. That's what we want. Swinging at streamers, been super productive today. Just getting a little bit of reverse drift. The last second has led to some really nice strikes. Boom. Look at that fish. Gorgeous rainbow. There you go, bud. Don't worry. We practice catch and release here. You got nothing to worry about, my friend. Nothing to worry about.
So let's get this healthy rainbow back where it should be. So I'm feeling really good about this little tributary that I found. I'm going to throw them some natural stuff. Try to pick up some of these wild fish. Using... what is it? A rainbow warrior... rainbow warrior and a pink beaded hare's ear.
Come on, fish. I'm using barbless hooks.
Good. Yes. Got one. Got a wild brownie. Just what the doctor ordered. Stuck him right in the top of the lip. He took the rainbow warrior. So, nothing huge, but a really nice wild fish. Can't beat it. Just inside. There he goes. Just where he's supposed to be, and rewarded me with a strike. Very cool. There we go. Small stream brownie to the net. That's why we come up these tribs. Ugh. Gorgeous fish too. Stunner.
The hook's already out of them too. Look at that. So I released that fish. I didn't do it on camera like I usually do. Let me just explain, you know, again, what I'm using. It's a 10-foot Syndicate 3 weight, Lamson liquid, 4 or 5, just to offset the weight, get it even. I am using today some flies that I tied. So let me clear it off a little bit. So here are the flies that I'm using today. I'm using a pink beaded hare's ear, and I'm using probably about 12 to 18 inches up a tungsten, or excuse me, a rainbow warrior. And to explain why I was able to get that fish, here's what I see. A feeding lane up ahead, a feeding lane there, and a feeding lane there and there. That's 4 lanes of current that feed directly into where that fish was sitting. So as I approach this small stream, I am hunting for the most favorable locations that is gonna just produce a lot of food for these fish. So I wouldn't be surprised to get into another one, or, you know, something to that effect in one of these other lanes, or maybe even in the same lane, but that was the best fish in that lane. And he immediately just clamped down on that feeding. So he was sitting in those riffles here in early March, actually mid-March, you know, mid-coronavirus really, just trying to gorge on some food. So what a great way to get away from people, do some social distancing, as they call it, and get a little closer to some fish. Got a hit from distance. See if we can't entice him to hit a second time. There we go. That's why you stay out of the water, so you pick up some of the fish. So nice little wild brown. Tangled up my fly style. I have to untangle whenever you go loose. I got about 20 minutes of film left. I do have an extra memory card, but I'm gonna basically time myself to only fish that. Try to pick up 1 or 2 more fish. He's gone, but got exactly what we were looking for, right at the head of that riffle. So let's work it up. That's one fish. We said we wanted 1 or 2 more. So you got one. All right, got a nice little soft spot of green. We're gonna try to drift it from distance and pick one off in the riffles like that other one. There we go. Sometimes you just get in the zone and the fish react. Process is definitely right. They're right where we've been calling shots. So that's exciting. So here's another little wild brown. We'll send him back home. What a great stream. I'd read about it. I'd walked close to it. Never made it all the way there. Today, made our mark, making good on it. Great little hole right here. I might have been a little high right there walking up. Just trying to stay out of the water. I walked over here, but might have spooked some fish. It could be in this hole, so we're gonna sneak behind, try to get in there. There we go. And there he goes. So I didn't want to set the hook too hard. If you look all around me, I got nothing but trees. So that could be to your detriment sometimes, where, you know, you don't set the hook hard enough, you lose a fish like that, or save yourself from getting a hard hook set and stuck in the trees like that. I didn't even set the hook hard there. There we go. That was pretty cool. It's a nice one. These small stream brownies, I mean, you just can't beat it. Slid right out. Hop you out, bud. Nice take. All right, this is gonna be our last fish.
All right, that's gonna wrap it up. I just wanna thank everybody that watches the channel, has supported me. I mean, like I said, I haven't put out a video in 4 months, and I felt pretty bad about it, to be honest with you. And if you stuck with it, you've made it this far, and you've stayed subscribed, I really do, again, wanna thank you. So I look forward to 2020. I know it hasn't necessarily started. Here we are in mid-March, the best, especially with this coronavirus threat, but I'm glad to have gotten out. And I just happened to get a little far enough up to find this beautiful trib, and I was rewarded greatly. So thanks as always for watching, supporting the channel, and I'm eager to see what 2020 holds for me. Have a good one, guys. Tight lines.